playing Culpepper, and of course you were expecting me to be a sandwich. Sorry. I don't mean to brag, but I had a lot of potential as a child. Did not pan out. Don't know why. I personally blame my parents, and people always say, it's easy to blame your parents.
Yeah.
I wouldn't do it if it was hard. Family, though, man, family's complicated. My cousin and I, we're both convinced that the other one is the black sheep of the family. I found that out after he got out of prison, though, so...
I like my
heart! I'm pretty good about it. The jury's still out. Not in his case. I was hoping it fucking shut. Guilty. It's weird now. I have a 14-year-old daughter.
Oh. Yeah.
14. You know how to really piss off a 14-year-old?
Yeah.
No, there's no wrong answers. Great. It's cool though, kids change. I was driving down the highway the other day, I see the sign that says, you need roadside assistance, dial pound 999. I did not read pound. I read hashtag. Called home, grounded my daughter. She's like, what the hell did I do? All I know is before you got here, there was a pound sign. Sometimes a tic-tac-toe board, maybe, that's it. But you know, kids can change you for the better, it's true. I quit smoking. Frequently. That shit is hard. Who knew? Worse than the drinking, though, is worse than smoking is the drinking, which I had to cut back on. But I didn't really know that I had a drinking problem because of the way that our society loves to celebrate that particular addiction. It's great. We don't do that with any other addictions. And I guess that's probably for the best. But you know, you won't walk into a party and see some people throwing ping pong balls and cups of crystal meth. You're never gonna walk by a soccer mom or yoga pants and sweatshirt that says, it's opium o'clock somewhere. I'm gonna stay in this bag of glue. Makes sense. It's terrible. But, you know, my family's fucked up, but not the family I made. That family's good. My daughter's great. My wife's great. My wife is, I don't even know how I lucked out with her, man. She has a great relationship with her parents, so it's hard to get her to do weird stuff in bed. Celebrated our anniversary. We have now been together for fucking ever. I'm kidding, it's great. I love it. Sorry. you get together, you've been together so long that things get old and you want to switch it up a little, try something new, and it's so hard to come up with new ideas. So this year for our anniversary, I did something really special. I hired a dominatrix. It's fucking great, dude. She picked a restaurant. She told us what movie to go to. We got home. Our daughter's chores were done. I bet she doesn't use hashtags anymore. I'm going to touch on the drinking one more time, just because it's an important issue. I mean, you guys are doing the right amount of drinking. Don't let me bring you down. No, we're fine. But it's weird in our society. I used to win drinking contests. And it's because it's easier to get a trophy than the help you so desperately need. But I'm going to turn it around. I'm going to start my own drinking contest. Winner gets an intervention. Congratulations, dude. Your body should not be able to do that. Here's a trophy of a guy passed out with dicks drawn on his face. Here's your mother and a bunch of people who love you. That's a good homie. Everybody, that's a great homie.